everybody and welcome on my YouTube channel. You are with Alan Rees for today's second review of Inferno. When I tested him in the past, he was a 1 star and red with 3 items. Now he's 5 stars and full gear red 1. I also can push him red 2, but it will be really good for the test that we want to do. This hero is actually in the Soul shop, so it's interesting, I think, for the people to know if they can invest on him or not, because when you are not an old player, you don't have perhaps so much resources to waste if this hero is not interesting. So we will see first time in Arena and Grand Arena what we can do with him, so in PvP, and second time in PvE, because it appears that this hero is really interesting for PvE in red, and, when you have some different kind of red. I didn't check before which red is open for me now, but I hope I could show you some examples, some good examples. Before all of that, I want to attract your attention about the last patch that came in the game, because some really important information came out. So it's now, let's discover the last free patch. So I want just to attract your attention about the 3 last patch, because in the 3 last patch, if you are not aware, you miss some really important information. First information in the patch of the 1st of July, increase the VIP cap to 15 level from 15 till 20. It's not huge, but for the money of you cool, I think it will be amazing, because you can imagine that VIP 20 is something like $200,000. So I hope that I will never see one player who did it. Already I know one VIP 19 and it's $60,000 or $70,000. It's some huge money, but everyone is able to do what he wants. Second point, improve the guild tournament server's matching formula. It's interesting, I'm sure, but I totally don't know what it is. So if you saw one modification in your grand tournament, I'm really interested to know how it's worked, because from my side, I didn't see anything. Second patch, 4th of July. So if you see first point, it's not interesting. Second point, improve the second skill of Manipulator. What's happened? The second skill of Manipulator was not full screen, is now full screen. So you can know it. It was wrote on the forum, and it's a good information even if it's not a revolution. Bug fix, we don't care in this case. And now the last patch of the 6th of July, from today. Improve the ultimate skill of Dual Wield. It will be the hero that we will unlock for most of us tomorrow. Okay, it's good that they improve. We didn't try the first version, so we'll see. Adjusted the position of Finslayer. Don't worry, it's not a revolution another time. Before, it was the most back frontliner that we could find. Now, he's just in front of Griffin and behind all the others. So, okay, they did this adjustment, why not? Now, bug fix. First one, we don't care. Second one, we don't care. Last one, it's a little revolution in the game. Fix a bug that the silence resistant gear did not work. It means actually, if you was playing with a caster, intelligence hero, you shouldn't be able to resist from the silence. So when you was playing healing team, when you was playing a full caster team, if the opponent was playing with deathmage, sorceress or a silencer, he was landing his silence 100%, so it was more easy. If you are now playing stall team, timeout team, it will be really more difficult to kill you. I did this morning some tests with Death Knight, Death Knight, Soul Hunter, Cleric, Chaplain, and Turtle Fighter. This team is now really, really difficult to kill, because most of the time you have one of the healers who resist, and sometimes two of them who resist from the silence. So it's all for now, but you should know that this bug fix of today was really, really important in the future of the game, for the future of the game. Let's now continue our review. Let's do a quick refresh about his skills that everybody has in memory the right thing. So we have one sort of fireball who will be like frost mage and boons by enemy, so who deal good amount of damage. You have one fire strike with one stun, You have one fire pillar with one area damage for small range, and you have one damage over time with his ultimate, who is targeting the weakest enemy. So it's interesting to get. Let's check his result in 1v1.
Round 1, fight!
So for the 1v1, another time I choose especially two heroes to get the benefit of his ultimate to will have the boons, because if he's alone he will touch only one target and it's not so efficient. So we can see that the fire pillar dealing a good amount of damage, something like 15k damage. It's really nice because it's area damage. The dot, another time the fire pillar, 13 and 20k, so it's not bad. The stun, and we'll see now the ultimate who will boons. Between 17 and 19k damage, it's really nice too. And if we see, all the damage are really interesting for this hero right now. Also, the stun is something really good. Don't forget that it targets the damage over time is targeting the more weakest hero. So if we check the damage, 237k when you have only two heroes in front of him. Okay, I didn't forget the clone of Fallen Dominion who grown up damage for a while, don't worry. But it's kind of interesting for the moment, and we will have to see now in full fight how it's going on. The first duel is damage test. Like you know, I like to see it when the damage dealer is not disturbed, how much damage he is able to do. So you have to know that we can know some other information. First of all, we see that the energy of Inferno is little low to grown up. So this is one point who is not so good for him, but this didn't change until the first review. Second point about his skill, now that we have two new heroes who are able to focus the weaker enemy, it's really interesting to know that his fire for skill is able to target the weakest enemy too. So we have, if we combine Tarot Prophet, Desert Lycan, Fiend Slayer, and this kind of hero and Inferno now, we will have a great combination of nuker to kill the weakest enemy. The ultimate. I like this ball. For the fan of manga, I'm thinking every time about the Genki-Dama of Dragon Ball. So we'll have the result, how much damage it deals by quantity. Ta-da! Nearly 300k damage, so it's really nice in damage. It's pure damage, like you saw, when he's not disturbed, when he's all the enemy are in front of him. So for sure, I give him the opportunity to deal a good amount of damage. But if you remember yesterday, the test of Fiend Slayer, in the same situation, Fiend Slayer was able to do 100k damage, not more. So the difference is really big. Let's see now in a position of fight. The second situation that I want to show you is the situation when in front of you, you don't have team who is able to mess you. So I play specially with Devastator to pack the enemy team, and Ghost Knight is there for the same targeting, because all the spell of Inferno will be able to touch everyone in the screen if you have this. I play with Lightbringer to take the damage of the Tarot Prophet, because he's weaker than Inferno, and for the rest we can see what's happened. We'll have the ultimate of Inferno now, and the ultimate of Ghost Knight in the same time, so it will regroup all and do BRAM! And finally, we push the team really strong. Okay, so let's check the statistic of the fight. We have our three damage dealer, even if normally Devastator is not a main damage dealer. We are able to do a good amount of damage and a really great control for the enemy team. So you can see that this hero, when you have in front of you one situation without enemy who is able to mess you, the damage can be really good even if in a short fight. Let's see now the last possibility when you have messing of your team. For the last fight I want to show you in against Turtle Fighter, how it's going on, because he's messed this time, and for sure his damage will be little lower because his fire pillar is not able to touch every hero. Even what we can learn by this duel, his pool of HP is really low. When he gets hit by Puppet Master, for example, he gets a lot of damage in the face. And the last point, if you remember about his position in the battlefield, it's not a lot of heroes who are behind him in the battlefield, so it's difficult to protect. If you have, for example, Arcane Sapper in front of him, Puppet Master in front of him, or Tarot Prophet in front of him, he will kill him totally quickly if you are not able to protect him with a healer. So I really think that Inferno is a good damage dealer for sure, but he needs to be well protected to give the best of his potentiality. We will see now the end of the fight and how much damage he was able to deal. So 114, even if he died really quickly, early by than the other, he dealt the most damage. So it's interesting as a damage dealer, like I told, just has to work about the brainstorming for the team to make him survive. I promise that as introduction that I will show you how he's working in PvE, and I will do it right now. So here is the red fight. I hope that I will have enough RNG. So let's go. This is not a good point for the moment. Okay, another time. Like that, it's not bad. I hope I will time. I will have time second time to ultimate. It will be nice. Allez. Yes. Okay, so let's check the result. If we check the result, for sure, Beer Warrior will be first. But we can see that we have one hero who is able to do 500k damage with a lot of interrupts, so it's difficult to be sure. He will be usually little behind the sorceress, but he is able to deal really nice amount of damage, like you see, and in PvE it's a really really good possibility of choice when you have a lot of enemy in front of you, because his AoE is really strong. Let's see now my final advice about this hero after to have upgraded him as 5 stars. Just to show the second run, 600,000 damage, you can see that it was pretty better due to the RNG directly when you have this kind of fight with hero who can make you fly or something. But usually he's just little behind the sorceress, like I told in the first try. So let's see now my advice for real. Finally, my final advice for Inferno is for sure if you have resources to invest on him in the Soul Shop, because actually if you check what you have in the Soul Shop, you have Swordmaster who is close to be a garbage, you have Catfencer who is definitively a garbage, and you have Inferno who is a good value for PvE and really a good value for PvP. So his only weakness is about his HP, and he's really squishy. Like I showed you before, he has 33k HP in the level 102, 5 stars and full red one with full enchantment. It's not that much, and even his magical resistance and armor are really low. So in my opinion, it's one hero who must be protected to get the better of his possibility. And be careful, his second minus is about his position in the battlefield, because this hero is really far behind and he doesn't have so much possibility to protect him behind him. So it's all for my advice and for the second review of Inferno. It's now time to conclude. Thank you everybody for watching my second review of Inferno. I hope that you enjoyed it. Like usual, don't hesitate to like the video and subscribe to my channel if you discover it for the first time. This evening I will be on live stream at 8 o'clock 30 minutes GMT3. The link of my streaming will be available in the description on the video and is also available on my presentation page on YouTube, so you can find me everywhere. I tell you bye bye everybody, see you on evening.